Need to block somebody from your Facebook business page? First of all, sorry to hear that. Second of all, most of the things on a Facebook business page are public by default, and there's not a whole lot you can do about it. But if there is somebody that's giving your page trouble, there are some things you can and can't do in terms of removing them, and we'll run through them all right now. What's up, busy people? Welcome to 5 Minute Social Media. If you've struggled with your social media marketing, feel like you're putting in all this effort, not getting anything in return, you're in a great place. Every week we put out a quick video like this one to help you with a different piece of your social media marketing strategy. So if that sounds like something you could use, take a second, hit subscribe, click that bell, and that way you'll be notified every week when we release another helpful video. My name is Jerry Potter, and today we're gonna show you where and how you can block somebody from your Facebook business page. Sucks that you're in that situation, that it can't just be public and everybody just gets along, but sometimes it happens. All right, I'm gonna show you a few different areas of the Facebook business page. Because if somebody just made some comment and they're probably not gonna come back, it's not an ongoing problem, you don't necessarily need to ban them from the page immediately. But let's say somebody left a comment that I didn't like, I can come down here, I've got a couple of options. You can go ahead and just delete the comment, but an alternative idea is simply to hide the comment. So I click these three little dots next to the comment, and then I can choose hide comment. And what that will do is it will just hide the comment from everybody except, in this case, this woman, Jen. She'll be able to see it as well as her friends, but nobody else can see it. So the reason that you do this is, let's say somebody leaves some angry complaint and you just decide to delete it. Well, I've seen it where somebody then comes back and goes, oh, I see you're deleting my complaints now, so I guess I'll just start leaving 10 more. And next thing you know, you've got complaints and profanity and stuff across all these different areas of your social media and you can't even keep up. But if you hide it, they got to vent and then you move on with your life. Another suggestion is, if you are gonna hide it but you want to address it, is first, anybody who comments on your business page, you can actually send them a direct message. So go through and say, hey, I saw your comment about such and such, I'm sorry you had that experience, whatever it might be, and then come back and hide it. So you're kind of getting the best of both worlds. Worst case scenario, you can just delete it. You just run that risk of that person going a little crazy and deciding to post on 10 of your social media posts every day for the rest of your life because they have more free time than you do. So use it somewhat sparingly. Another thing people ask about all the time is, what if I get a bad review? Can I delete it? No, reviews cannot be deleted. So you can either have your reviews on your page on or off. You turn them off, then they're all gone, but one bad review cannot be deleted. Just like before, you can send them a private message, or your options are to give feedback on this recommendation. And if somebody posted nudity in a photo, or it was unfair, it wasn't relevant, it clearly wasn't about your business, you can click that and send it. And if somebody saw it and they're like, oh, you're a plumber, and this is clearly about a restaurant, why is it here? If there's hate speech, any of these types of things, then you can report it, somebody from Facebook will review it and possibly take it down. Now the last thing, if you just wanna get somebody off of your page and they just aren't letting go, you deleted their comment and they did continue to post 10 times a day to drive you crazy. Well, in that scenario, you're gonna click settings at the top of your page. Then on the left, click people and other pages. Search for their name. I'm using this person because this is an account I have access to, and so I want to show you what they see on the other end once you have banned them. So I click their name, I come up here to this little gear icon, and I click ban from page. It says, would you like to ban Jen Park? Confirm. Jen has been banned. To see a list of people banned, see your page settings. So now she has been banned. So now if I go to her account, visit my page again. She can still see it, kind of like a website. But if I come down here, you'll notice there is no option to comment on anything. I can click the comments and I can read them, but she can no longer post to anything. And she did not get a notification saying, hey, you've been kicked off the page. If you ban somebody by accident, go ahead and go to the banned people and pages list, click on them, and then you can unban them from the page. So that's how you ban somebody if they have liked your page, but what if they've never liked your page? There's no easy way to like preemptively ban somebody because you think they're gonna do something bad. But as soon as they do comment or engage in some way, so here's our friend Jen again, I can click the three dots, I can click hide comment, and then right there, I can ban Jen Park. Got any questions or comments about what I showed you? Go ahead and leave them in the comments of this video. And you might be interested in our free 5-minute Facebook facelift, all about how to optimize your Facebook business page for profit. It's free. Grab it. Link is in the description of this video. Thank you so much for watching. If this was helpful, share it with someone else who might enjoy it. Give it a like, click subscribe. You're not only supporting me, but also my two tiny superheroes at home.